Greetings, fam. This is Will of Chile Coney. Today we're going to explore the bass line of the song Use Me by Bill Withers, which was released in 1972. This bass line was played by Melvin Dunlap, who also played the bass line on Express Yourself. One of the reasons I like Melvin Dunlap is that, like James Jamerson, Carol Kay, Alfonso Johnson, Doug Dunn, and Rocco Pastia, he doesn't use a lot of slapping and popping or thumping to make the music funky. Now, don't get me wrong, slapping and popping and thumping are true artistic styles of playing the bass and are really worthwhile skill sets to master if you want to be a bass player. But Melvin Dunlap and the rest of these bass players that I just mentioned rely on a heavy groove and syncopation in order to move the song along. They did this without slapping, thumping, or popping. They just really found the groove, and with a little bit of syncopation, they just locked in with the drummer, the guitar player, and the keyboard player. Another reason I picked this bass line for a tutorial is because the musicians are really, really, really funky. Some of these musicians are from the Charles Wright and Watts 103rd Street Rhythm Band. The drum beat by James Gadson, who was the drummer on this particular cut, was sampled a lot. It was sampled by Kendrick Lamar, sampled by Nas and Logic. Another real important reason for choosing this song is because Bobbye Hall is one awesome percussionist, is on this cut as well. She played on 22 top 10 hits back in the 70s and 80s. So the bass line of this song is based upon two chords, the E7 sharp 9. And A7. Now I'm going to show you this bass groove, and it's a really simple groove. It's basically on the E string, the A string, and the E string. Okay? And there's a little bit on the D string, but mainly it's the A. And it's mostly chromatic. And then one partial outline of a chord. Another chromatic. Okay? So it's basically E to E. D, D sharp E. And then B, B flat A. And then the turnarounds are like this. Okay, so let's go over some of the turnarounds. Like I said, all chromatic. It hits that A with the baby finger. And then he does the same thing. Well, actually, I don't hear him do that, the first one, this one. I do that one, but he also does, and he also does where he anticipates a little bit or delays. Another quick thing I wanted to show you was just to show you how the chords look, that E7 sharp 9 on a MIDI keyboard. At the bottom note is E, then G sharp, and the next note would actually be B, but on guitar you wouldn't play the B, you'll play a D next,
and then you'll have a G natural at up the top. So you have the G sharp here and the G natural here. That's what gives it that really kind of funky kind of sound of the E 7 sharp 9 chord. And then on the other side, you have the next chord is the A7 chord, and you have the A right here. The next note would be a G. Then the C sharp. And then another G up top. You also probably can hear the E in there too. Yeah, you should be able to hear that in there too. So. Now I think that he's playing in every two bars, I believe. No, it's actually every one bar. Let's just try it like that. See if we can try it in time a little bit. Let's change the time to 77.7. Okay, let's see how it sounds with a drum beat. Next, I would like to show you how those guitar chords will look on a guitar chord chart. Okay, that's it for now. That's the bass line. Those are the guitar chords, and you also showed you how they look on the keyboard. Great song, Use Me, by Bill Withers and members of Charles Wright 103rd Street Watts Rhythm Band. I think I said that right. All right, peace.